what attracted me to SCT was people who I really respected in my professional organization were excited about it, and passing on pieces of both theory and methodology that were really interesting to me.
But I sensed there is it brought up issues about group dynamics that I felt, but I couldn't address in a model that suited me then. So first hearing and experiencing SCT made me more and more curious about, wait a minute, there's things going on I know, and now I can give words to it.
And I was very early on struck by all the similarities with family systems work, which is had been all through my graduate school. That's kind of what my focus was.
I was working in a company where I felt we didn't have a common ground or a common theory, and that was a problem. And at one point, SCT was introduced to us in the company by one of the owners.
I encountered it in a therapeutic context, but then I saw the applications to my work and felt excited about it right away.
What's kind of maintained my interest is the idea that the more you do, the bigger you kind of become inside, the more you can accommodate really in the world.
But clinically, I've used it for years and continue to really be impressed, not impressed actually, completely surprised still about the impact that it has on people and its effectiveness in a moment-to-moment changes.
Group therapy with patients and group of staffs is useful for me in the workplace. That is first. But it has become important for me in everyday life now.
Half my caseload is couples, and that's just naturally developed. And I think it's honestly because of SCT, I'm thinking in terms of systems. A lot of the ways of theory is a very nice entree into working with couples. SCT has really helped me to understand how to actually go in and think about that individual or that system of the couple or the group.
I'm a biologist and geographer by training. So where SCT comes in, the way I use my system-centered training skills, is that I use that test information to help people learn to subgroup by listening and understanding the information that other people are giving them, so that information becomes more accessible to people.
So I'm an organizational consultant and a coach, and when I'm working with a team, if I can have an eye on both what's happening in me and then what's happening in the group, I have a whole extra set of data that I can draw on that helps me know what to do next with the group. And because in SCT we see so much how each member and the leader are part of the group, there's more of an emphasis of really learning yourself, kind of yourself as an instrument, in addition to learning the theories and the concepts.
And then the challenge is, how do I then take this out into my world, my work? What of this can I then bring, and what adaptation will be needed for it to fit and to be as satisfying there as it is here? So that's what I'm left with every time I do this.
I think it's deceptively simple and actually very difficult to learn. But there's also something about SCT becoming more of a way of being that kind of takes you by surprise. Like, you know, I can realize that I might not have formally done something for a while, but I feel as though I'm further on somehow in what I know and understand and what I do.
I fairly early on started using it as my major method of working with people. So that isn't challenging, because I mean, it's challenging to do, but it's also, I get better results in working any other ways than I have. And so it's immediately gratifying as well as being challenging. I can really help people who I couldn't help before. And often people have gone to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 therapists therapies help them sort of make it through life, but not really get at the deep level things that help them change.